Hello students, welcome to AJ Akshar Academy YouTube channel. In this session, I am going to discuss re-optics and optical instruments, refraction. If you like this video, please like, share and subscribe to our channel. Please share your valuable comments in the comment section. Okay, let us go to the today's session first. Now next topic, refraction. When a ray of light incident obliquely on a surface separating two transparent media, its direction changes at the surface. This phenomena is called refraction. So the phenomenon of light ray, whenever the light ray traveling from one medium to another medium, resulting the change in direction. So this phenomena is known as refraction. Okay. Now this is the refraction of the acoustic waves. So this is an acoustic waves here. This is optically rarer medium and it is optically denser medium. Now the light ray or incident ray traveling from rarer to denser. This is the normal. Now this refracted ray bends towards the normal. So here at an interface, the light ray is bending. So simply the bending beam of light is also known as refraction. Here the angle between incident ray and normal is known as angle of incidence, and the angle between normal and refractor ray is known as angle of refraction. Okay, now next, Snell's law. The ratio of the sine of the angle of incidence to the sine of the angle of refraction is constant and is called a refractive index n r mu of the second medium with respect to first medium. So Snell's law states that the ratio of sine of angle of incidence to the sine of angle of refraction is constant and is called as refractive index. It is denoted by letter n r mu. So it is given by sin I by sin r is equals to n2 by n1, that is equals to n21, that is equals to n12, refractive index of the second medium with respect to first medium, where n1 is the refractive index of first medium, where n2 is the refractive index of second medium. Or this can be written as n1 sin I is equals to n2 sin r. So now, but n1 is equals to c by v2, n2 is equals to c by v2, n1 is equals to c by v1, but absolute refractive index n is equals to c by v, that is ratio of speed of light in vacuum by speed of light in medium gives the absolute refractive index, where c is velocity of light in vacuum and v is velocity of light in medium. So therefore n2 by n1 is equals to c by v2 into v1 by c. cc gets cancels, v1 by v2, that is equals to f lambda 1 by f lambda 2. Since v is equals to f lambda, velocity of light in a medium, v is equals to f lambda, that is v is equals to n lambda. Here f nothing but frequency. So therefore n21 is equals to n2 by n1, or v1 by v2, that is equals to lambda 1 by lambda 2. This is the relation between frequency and velocity and wavelength. So n21 is equals to, in terms of refractive indices, n2 by n1, in terms of velocity is v1 by v2, in terms of wavelength lambda 1 by lambda 2. In terms of frequency, f lambda 1 by f lambda 2. Here during refraction, frequency does not change. Only velocity and wavelength will change. And n21 is equals to, we can write as 1 by n12. So the reciprocal of n12 gives n21. It is called optical reversibility. Okay, next. Now discuss note. In refraction, the frequency f does not change, but velocity and wavelength will change. So during refraction, frequency remains constant. So next, If n2 is less than n1, then r is less than I and the refractive ray bends towards normal. So this is here we are taking the normal and it is denser medium and it is rare medium. Incident ray falls from this rare medium to denser medium and it is angle between normal and incident ray, that is angle of incidence. Now the refractive ray towards normal. Here angle of refraction is less than angle I. So if n2 is less than n1, then r is less than I and refractive ray bends towards the normal. Next, if n2 is greater than n1, then r is greater than I and the refractive ray bends away from the normal. So here this is the n1 and n2 two refractive indices. And it is in this case r is greater than I. So now the incident ray falls from rarer medium, denser medium to rare medium. So now first incident ray is traveling from denser medium to rarer medium. The refractive ray moves away from the normal. So in this case angle of refraction is greater than angle of incidence. So that's why refractive ray bends away from the normal. Next, now we'll discuss applications of refraction. When a refraction of light takes place through a rectangular glass slab, the emergent ray is parallel to the incident ray and there is no deviation, but the ray suffers lateral displacement or shift with respect to incident ray. Now we are taking the glass slab and this thickness of glass slab is T. This is the incident ray. And it is, we are drawing the normal and whenever the incident ray strikes the point of incidence and it is on the reflected surface. So now the incident ray traveling from rare medium to denser medium, the refractive ray moved towards the normal and now in this glass, this is now the incident ray traveling from denser to rarer, that is glass to air, the emergent ray is away from the normal. So actually this is the incident ray path without any medium. So whenever we are extending the incident ray and emergent ray, these two are parallel. So there is no angle between extended incident ray and emergent ray. So this is the difference. The distance between incident ray and emergent ray is known as lateral shift. Okay, next. Now this is here we are taking lateral shift delta x and we are drawing the normal and we are taking the angle of incidence I and angle of refraction r and here angle of emergence e. Now from triangle AMB cos r is equals to AM by AB. Now from this we are writing AB is equal to AM by cos r, that is AM nothing but T by cos r. So now since AM is equals to T, that is thickness of the glass slab. So distance traveled by light inside the glass slab is AB is equals to T by cos R. Now next, from triangle ABC, this is ABC. So from this sine of I minus R is equal to BC by AB. So BC is equals to delta X, that is equals to AB sine of I minus R. So delta x is equals to T by cos r into cos sine of I minus r. So therefore lateral shift, this is the lateral shift. So the lateral shift delta x is equals to T by cos r into sine of I minus r. Okay, next. Now the bottom of a tank filled with water appears to be raised when viewed along the normal direction. So due to refraction, whenever observing along the normal direction, the bottom of the tank filled with water, water level appears to be raised. Here this is the position real depth and T and this is the apparent depth. Whenever we have a normal direction, looking like to be water level is appears to be raised. This is the shift delta T. Now here we are calculating the shift delta T. Real depth is T. Now for air refractive index is n1 is equals to 1 and this is the apparent depth. So now refractive index of water with respect to air is N21 is equals to real depth by apparent depth, that is T by T dash. So N21 is equals to N2 by N1, that is equals to T by T dash. So N is equals to T by T dash. N1 is the one for rarer medium, that is air. So N2 is equals to N for denser medium, that is water. Now from the figure, shift delta T is equals to real depth minus apparent depth, that is T minus T dash. So here we are taking the N is equals to T by T dash, that implies T dash equals to T by N. Substituting the place of T dash, T by N, then we are taking T as a common, the remaining is 1 minus 1 by N into T. So delta T is equals to 1 minus 1 by N into T. Now therefore shift delta T is equals to 1 minus 1 by N into T, where T is the thickness of water or real depth. Now note, we'll discuss note here. This is the air and it is a river. Now we are taking rarer medium of air is, that is refractive index of air is equal to 1, and refractive index of denser medium, here we are taking N2 is equals to N. Now it is the incident ray. Now incident ray traveling from rarer to denser, it is refractive ray move towards the normal. This is the incident ray. It is T real depth and it is apparent depth T dash. Now delta T. Now this is the shift. Now we will calculate. In this, if the observer is in the denser medium and the object is in rare medium, then the apparent depth is more than the real depth. So refractive index of water with respect to air is given by N21 is equals to apparent depth by real depth. This is T dash by T. So N21 is equals to N2 by N1. Here N1 is a 1 for rarer medium, that is air. N2 is equals to N for denser medium, that is water. Now therefore N is equals to T dash by T. So shift delta T is equals to apparent depth minus real depth, that is T dash minus T. Delta T is equals to here N, since N is equals to T dash by T, from this we can write as T dash equals to N into T. So in the place of this T dash we can write N T, then we can take T as a common. So then shift delta T is equals to, we are getting N minus 1 into T. Now next, here we are discussing the apparent position of the sun. So due to the refraction of sunlight through the atmosphere, the sun is visible a little 2 minutes before the actual sunrise and a little 2 minutes after the actual sunset, and the apparent flattening of the sunset and sunrise also due to refraction. This is the horizon and it is the atmosphere. Now we are looking the apparent position of the sun. So due to refraction, first sunlight through the atmosphere, the sun is visible before the actual sunrise and after the actual sunset. So little bit 2 minutes before the actual sunrise and a little 2 minutes after the actual sunset. Okay, next. Now I will discuss MCQs. First one, mathematical form of Snell's law is N2 sin I is equals to N1 sin R, N1 sin R is equals to N2 sin I, and N1 sin I is greater than N2 sin R, and N1 sin I is equals to N2 sin R. The mathematical formula for Snell's law is N1 sin I is equals to N2 sin R. So option D is the correct answer. So N1 sin I is equals to N2 sin R is the mathematical form of Snell's law. Next, when light ray travels from one medium into another medium, then which of the following quantity remains same? Wavelength, frequency, velocity, refractive index. So during refraction, frequency remains same. So when the light ray travels from one medium to another medium, Which of the following quantities remains same? Nothing but wavelength, velocity will change. Only frequency remains same. So that is frequency does not change. So the second option is correct. Frequency remains same. Okay. Thanks for watching this video.